Casper from Spreadsheeter here, and the first step to inserting and using a line chart is to select the data that you want to go into the chart. That was an easy step number one. So for step two, go to insert up here and select the line chart. Use this one right here because it's the one chart that fits any scenario. Like this. Well, that's basically it, right? Step number three is obviously to subscribe to this channel. Nah, just kidding, but feel free to do so. The real step number three is to modify the chart so it fits your needs. And that's what you want to do with any chart in Excel, and there are endless possibilities of doing so. I'm going to boil it down to three tips to modifying your line chart. And the first one is to make it look good with chart styles. So select your chart and then go up here in the chart design tab under chart styles, and if you click here you get these 13 predefined templates that you can use for your line chart. So let's hover the cursor above some of these, like this one for example. This and this and this for example looks pretty great. Also this, pretty fancy, right? You really want to use some of these chart designs, and what fits best for you, it's hard to say, but I like this one. It's really simple. It just has some nice shadows on it. I like it for a lot of scenarios. Also, it's white on a white background as opposed to this, which is black on a black background. So pick the one you think fits the best. By the way, I just want to give a quick mention of my free online Excel training. You can go to my website, scroll down the page, and just click on the level you want to start with. So if you want to get started with using functions and references and stuff like that, you can click here. If you want to learn more about great functions like if, sumif, and VLOOKUP, click here. And if you want to learn more about macros and VBA, you need to pick one of these. So just click on the button and sign up with your email address, and I'll send it to you right away. It's free, it's awesome. Go to spreadsheeter.com/YouTube to sign up. So back to my tip number two for getting an awesome line chart, and that is to add or remove elements. And you can do that from the plus button up here. And there are plenty of options to add stuff and remove stuff. You can remove the axis if you want to do that. That's probably pretty stupid, but if you want to change them, you can go here and remove some of them or get more options. If you click here, you can include data labels. That's a very popular one, and you can change them. If you click this arrow right here, change the position, for example, data callout like this, or do more options here. Obviously, there's the infamous trend line you can add right here. I'm not gonna dive more into this here, but that's how we get started with it. Tip number three for getting an awesome line chart is to understand that you can modify everything on a chart. You can format it as you want it. So a popular one to do is to format the axis, and that you can do by right-clicking it and hit format axis. And over here, there are plenty of options that you can get lost in, but these axis options are pretty cool. You can set the minimum, for example, and the maximum. That means that you can change what numbers are shown on the left axis here. So if you want to set the minimum to, let's say, 250,000, like this, hit enter. Yep, now the chart looks totally different, which might come in very handy for your situation. You can do similar stuff with everything, and you can change the color, for example, of this. If you click it, go to format, shape fill, no, shape outline, red, for example, anything you want, you can do with any chart in Excel like this. If you want to learn more about charts, you need to see this video about one of my favorite charts in Excel. To learn even more about Excel, click the link in the description to join my free online Excel training. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.